Long-term investing means that you buy and hold an asset for many years. We know that this is one of the best ways to become rich, but that doesn't mean simply holding a worst performing stock will make you rich. So here in this video, I'm going to share my thoughts on one of the best stocks that you can buy and hold for this decade. Let's get into the video. Hi, welcome to Let's Make Education Free channel. Thanks for the support. Here in this channel, we want to create valuable content, and creating valuable content always takes time. So please subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications when we upload a new video. All right, by this time, you would have probably guessed the stock that I'm going to talk about. It's none other than Tesla. So why is Tesla a long-term buy and hold? I'm going to tell you in four simple steps exactly why. One of the first things that's great about Tesla is its growth potential. It's not a company that has already grown and stagnated. It is still fast growing. Whole world is moving towards sustainable energy because we can't keep relying on fossil fuel. One day it's going to run out. So moving towards sustainable energy is the way to go. So with this in mind, we can see that Tesla plays a big role in this transition. We are currently at the beginning of the transition. So we still have a lot of work to do to achieve full sustainability. If you want to buy a stock and hold, we need to pick a stock with good growth potential. So basically, for this decade, Tesla is unavoidable. Next thing we need to look at is the stock's fundamentals. For Tesla, at its current price, it's around 400 billion market capital, and the share is trading around US$450. It has amazing potential to become highly profitable in the near future. After a long 10-year struggle, it has already shown positive earnings in the last 4 quarters. So from what I see, this is going to continue, and they are going to construct more gigafactories, so more cars will be produced and more revenue will be generated, which will eventually turn into profits. From a value investing point of view, P/E or P/S or other metrics, which will show that Tesla is currently overvalued. But we should not analyze a growth stock using this approach. Cars are a prominent part of the world we live in. Many people are ready to shift towards electric cars, but traditional automakers haven't made much progress in the electric space. But look at Tesla. Tesla's whole approach revolves around making cars 100% electric from scratch. While many OEMs are still looking at how to make hybrid EVs and less focused towards 100% electric vehicles. Since Tesla already thought about this 10 years ago, it is way ahead of its competition. The experience Tesla gained over the last 10 years will really help it to grow further. Now to the interesting part, innovation. Tesla is synonymous with innovation. In the world we live now, value investing is almost dead. Innovative and disruptive companies are the ones taking the lead and have potential to give good returns. Tesla is the king of innovation. They are super innovative. When you look at traditional automakers, they will take a long time to bring even a small change. But Tesla is not like that. They try to do everything in-house, and using the vertical integration, they can rapidly innovate and bring it to the final product. They have a big advantage in autonomous driving technology. 70 different parts are combined in one single casting and so on. So we can look at many similar things like this that shows how awesome Tesla is. And I think it's super hard for the competitors to catch up to Tesla because Tesla will zoom ahead even further and come up with something extraordinary. Now to the fourth point, they are not just car makers. This is an important point. Even Wall Street analysts do not give an important consideration to this. But what we need to know is Tesla is not just a car company, it's an energy company. Look at Tesla's mission. It is to accelerate the world's transition to sustainable energy. Given this, we shouldn't just look at it as a car company. It has solar panel, solar roof, batteries, and many more to come. I'll share with you some key highlights from the recent Tesla Battery Day. Tesla is going to produce batteries in-house because demand is skyrocketing and we need more and more batteries. And they can't be relying only on suppliers all the time, so they decided to do it in-house. They are going to achieve 54% increase in range, meaning it can make 2 cars instead of 1 using the same amount of battery cells. 56% price reduction at the battery pack level, so we can get a $25,000 car in the near future. and a 69% reduction in capital expense. These are all the benefits of Tesla's vertical integration. Tesla currently produces 30 gigawatt hour, and it took 10 years to reach this. But now with the new innovation, Tesla can produce 10 extra gigawatt hour in a year, and they are planning to produce 100 gigawatt hour in 2022 and 3 terawatts hour by 2030. To give some perspective, the whole world currently consumes around 18 terawatt hour of energy. So if Tesla manages to achieve 3 terawatt hour by 2030, this will be game changing. So please don't see Tesla just as an electric car maker. Look at it as an energy company that is going to change the world we live in. Next year, Model S Plaid, Cybertruck and Tesla Semi might be up for delivery. This year, they will achieve 500,000 deliveries, and by the end of 2030, they want to achieve 20 million cars delivered per year. So to summarize, it has high growth potential, fundamentally strong company, it's an innovative company, and they are not just car makers. I believe that with all of this, Tesla will help me to achieve my financial freedom. Thanks for watching this video. I put money where my mouth is. I'm not just giving advice. I'm already investing in Tesla. 30% of my portfolio is Tesla, and I'll keep adding. If you are an NRI, you have many options to get into Tesla. If you are a resident Indian, please check possibilities like Vested or Global Investing from HDFC, and there are many options out there. But I would ask you to start your SIP soon. Please don't just focus solely on Indian companies. You can also buy fractional shares. So don't think high share price is a factor to stop you. The party has already started and you're already late. But the important thing to remember is that the party is not over yet. I'm just a YouTuber. Take my opinions with a grain of salt. Do your analysis, and if your thoughts are aligned with mine, then start investing. Current price is indeed overpriced, but if you're buying now, please be ready to hold for the next 10 years. Please don't buy the stock for the short term. Thank you, and let me know in the comments if you have any doubts, and also do share with me your experience on investing in Tesla. All the best for your investment journey. Together, let's become rich and let's make education free.